The power of his dream brings you here. His man, Sean Carlard.
Now, surround yourself with people who believe in you and your dream more than you do until one day you believe it too. And that's on the servant leadership. Being the ultimate leader is serving and protecting your people. In the part where we teach you how to take care of you. Now, how do you surround yourself with people? Well, firstly, mentorship. And we taught you how to mentor or be mentored earlier in the course. Remember, with the stick figures, and thanks to those two wonderful people that participated live on radio, and it worked out incredibly well, and using WhatsApp, believe it or not. And then mentorship is very important because it increases your competence, and you can do it face-to-face and or cyber. So cyber means that you can connect with people, and I was doing it way before COVID, is you have face-to-face where you take people out for coffee and you enjoy time with people that add value to you, that you help grow, and in helping people grow, you grow within yourself. I am very good at what I do, and the reason why I'm very good at what I do is because I've spent so much time with you. I am the sum total of all the people that I've ever spent time with, and I've got all my expertise, my experience, and my wonderful knowledge from you guys. And all my stories, even though some people, and I have to have it as a disclaimer when I do training, my stories are true. I can give you a telephone number and you can speak to the person and you will find out that it is as good as what it is. So I'm really, really good at what I do because of the people around me. Does that make sense? So I like to spend time with people that add value to me and help me grow. If you want to be a millionaire, well, hang out with millionaires. But if you want to be a billionaire, you need to give up your millionaire friends because they are only going to teach you how to be a millionaire. If you want to be a soccer player, change your company. Spend a lot of time with people who are around soccer and you can work out the rest. Now, you've got to have friends. That's another way of connecting. Is I've been mentored. A lot of my leadership principles and skills in my foundation, John Maxwell is one of them. Chip Ingram is another. Joel Osteen is another. Creflo Dollar is another. T.D. Jakes is another. But when it comes to practical leadership, John Maxwell has mentored me. And even though I have met him, he has done all his conversations and mentoring. I used to get it on cassette tape from Amway at the time. And then videos. And I still get his daily videos. Still sends it to me. I've got his books. I have an application on my phone called Audible. And it's an Amazon app. And on Audible, you have a monthly subscription. And you can download books. Watchman Nee, I listen to his books there. John Maxwell, I've got lots of books on my audio application that I listen to constantly. And some books I do over and over again so that they can mentor me. They can share their stories. They can share their lives. And even though I don't see them face to face, they mentor me. And then also now with all the different multimedia that we have available, I sit down with people from the other side of the world, world champions in their lives. And I sit and I have a cup of coffee. In fact, somebody asked me now if I can do coffee this afternoon with him. And yeah, he used the word wrong, and I thought he was asking, not thought, I was tongue in cheek, are you asking me to pay for coffee? And he's like, no, I'm very bad. I want to start. Can we do it over WhatsApp? Yes, you can. You can have coffee with a friend over WhatsApp. You can even have a bra with him. You bra on your side, they bra on their side. The nice thing is some of the people I hang around with on the social media connections is they take me through their home, which I'll never have the opportunity to go in and see. But because of technology, I can mentor them in their homes, in their lives. And then friends. Friends is very, very important. And you want friends that add value to you. You need to tell your friends that this is the journey that I'm going to be taking. I want you to come along with me. And I need you to change your attitude, your mindset. And if they don't want to change, change them for somebody who will. Sometimes you have to let certain people go so that you can move on in life to take on others with you. Very, very important. And they must believe in you, hey? And your dream. You have an obligation to share your dream with people. Then vision. You want people who have vision. People who can see themselves going somewhere. You can see yourself becoming a head of a company. You can see yourself being a mother. You can have the vision of being an incredible father. You can have a vision of being the world's best soccer player. You can have a vision of traveling the world, but that is vision. You want to be around people who have vision, share their vision, and then it encourages you to be the hero of your story. Find people who are heroes of their story that will encourage you to be a hero of yours. As I was speaking to Papa earlier with the men wanting to give up and walk away, he has his own story, and that's why I asked him about his story, because in his story and being a hero in his story, he encourages us to be heroes in ours. So everybody has a story, and weirdly enough, whether you like it or not, your value is where you've come from. That's where you get your value to go to where you're going. The price that you have paid, the fact that you did not give up, the fact that you have not walked away, that you've taken a deep breath, that is amazing. You want to be around people that are on the carpet. They are on the mat. They are on the fighting floor. They are in the ring fighting the fight. And they are bleeding. And they've got a cut clip. And they've got a bruised eye. And they are tired and they're raggled. And as you fall on the mat and you bounce and you look and you go, yeah, can I get up one more time? And you look across and there's that person. I'm looking you in the eye. And going, I know it's sore, I know it's sad, and I know it's hard. But we know our why. You want people to be on that mat that know their why as you do. And I just look into your eyes and I feel your pain. I know it's not easy. And I know it's not nice, but it's necessary. But even though it's not easy, it's going to be worth it. It's not the first time I've been knocked down. And we don't get measured by the amount of times we get knocked down. We get measured as to how quick we stand back up.
The power of his dream brings you here, his man, Sean Carlard.